Welcome back. Teachers have resorted to a lot of crazy stunts to keep their students interested. But there's one at the Victoria University who has resorted to singing, and it seems to be working. He's just won a prize worth $20,000. Welcome, Dr Warwick Murray.
Thanks very much, Brendan.
Pleasure to have you on the show.
Pleasure to be here.
What makes you so different with the way or your teaching methods?
Well, thanks, Brendan. I think these awards were given to acknowledge excellence in teaching in the tertiary sector across New Zealand. I wasn't the only one to get one, mm-hmm. and I didn't get the Supreme Award, which was won by a chap called Carl Rove in Canterbury. My teaching is based on hard work and commitment and a passion for my subject. It's based on excellent collegial support and wonderful students. But there is a twist, I suppose, and that's certainly something that people have picked up on, and that's that I do incorporate music an awful lot into my teaching, both piped music, you know, through CD, CDs and so on, and live music that I write myself, based on the themes that I talk about in my work in geography.
Yeah, you're a senior lecturer in geography, so how do you put the music together with what you're teaching?
Well, I've always loved music, mm-hmm. and it's been a big part of my life, that's for sure, and most people I know and are friends with also love music. But geography is a subject, of course, which is about the world. Geography means write the world. Mm-hmm. That's what it means literally in Latin. And in that sense, it's kind of easy to incorporate music to illustrate the diversity of the planet and the issues that we face, the problems that we face. I also teach globalization. Mm-hmm. And globalization is about the way cultures are intermingling, economies are intermingling across the planet. And of course, there are many musical examples you can use to illustrate those points and those ideas. So I use music in every lecture, mm-hmm. not my own music necessarily. I use CDs to illustrate the themes of that particular topic. For example, I might begin a lecture on Latin America with bossa nova and then explain that bossa nova is a mixture of jazz, which comes from the States, which mm-hmm. has roots in blues. It's also a mixture of samba, which comes from slave music that was brought over to Brazil during the Portuguese colonial period. And so you can enter into the debate about Latin America through music. A musical example,
so they can feel it as well, the kids can feel it.
That's exactly it, you see, Brendan. The point is, by using music, I'm kind of seeking to transport the students to the field. Mm. We can't afford to take all our students to Brazil. I wish we could,
right.
You know, but we can't. So if you can feel a place and hear a place and taste a place,
just as good as being there.
I think so. It helps transport them to the field. It also helps them switch off from maybe the statistics lecture they were in before. It sets a kind of a marking point there. So I use those things. And also, I write my own music, which I incorporate occasionally into class. Not too often. I want them to come back, you know. But, and as I say, that draws on the themes. And the reason for doing that is that I feel very strongly about my subject.
Right.
My subject's about global problems and what we might do to solve them. Environmental destruction, poverty, inequality, mm-hmm. and all these terrible things.
Which you've written a book about, is that correct?
Oh, yeah, I have, actually. Brendan, thanks for mentioning that.
No worries.
Geographies of Globalization,
right.
Which is based on my research in Latin America and Chile and beyond.
Do you use music examples throughout the book that people can...
There is a section on the globalization of music, mm-hmm. And so on, but this is a more general discussion of globalization, the geographies of it, used for a third-year course at Victoria. So that's something I've just completed
cool.
late 2005. Thanks. Nice cover.
Nice cover.
Thanks, mate.
Nice plug. Now, the kids, how's it been received? Well, I shouldn't call them kids, young adults.
Yeah.
How's it been received by them?
And it is young adults, and it's sometimes mature students as well. But it is generally younger folk. And, well, I think they enjoy the music. I think they enjoy our subject and hopefully the way I teach it as well. I'm very committed and passionate about my subject. My purpose really is to enthuse students to want to learn and then create the space and the direction for them to do that learning themselves, mm. so they discover things for themselves. And when you do that, I think you retain things a lot better. You feel as if you own the knowledge and you discover things. So basically, I see myself as somebody who lights the fuse, stand back...
And let them go.
Controlled explosion, of course. Mm-hmm. You don't want too much mess. Mm-hmm. So you've got to have some direction and let it go.
Is anyone else using those methods throughout New Zealand or anywhere else in the world?
In terms of music, I would imagine...